Kenya has seen a major success in efforts to reduce child and maternal mortality with the announcement that came on 1st June 2013 with maternity and primary health care services declared free of charge. This was a major step towards universal health coverage.
The free maternal service has been a success, with the number of deaths of children under the age of 5 declining from 100,000 in 2013 to 70,000 currently, while mortality for mothers giving birth has declined from 6,000 in 2013 to 4,300 currently.
This year, the government has allocated 4.3 billion shillings to finance free maternal services, 900 million shillings for free primary health care, and 1.3 billion shillings for rollout of universal health cover to enhance efficient health care service delivery, and 1.3 billion shillings for rollout of universal health cover to enhance efficient health care service delivery.
Especially our 2016-2017 budget, to further support the program, I have allocated 4.3 billion for free maternity health care.
Kenya has reported increased challenges in the management of diseases, with patients seeking specialized services such as cancer screening, kidney dialysis and therapy across the borders. Patients have also been subjected to long queues at the Kenyatta National Hospital to ensure health facilities are equipped. 4.5 billion shillings has been allocated for leasing medical equipment.
To further support the managed equipment services and scale up the supply of specialized medical equipment to hospital, I have allocated 4.5 billion for lease of medical equipment.
To provide quality and accessible health care, 3.5 billion shillings for Kenya Medical Training Centers, 8.8 billion for Kenya National Hospital, 8.8 billion for Kenyatta National Hospital, 5.8 billion for Moi Teaching and Referral Hospital, 1.7 billion for Kenya Medical Research Institute, 3 billion shillings for doctors, clinical officers, nurses internship program, and 600 million shillings to National AIDS Control Council. Brenda Kiprono reporting for Channel 1 News Hour.